If time management is important to you while you work, then please stop using realistic threads in your designs. I know. Why do I say that? Well, it turns out that Solidworks really struggles when showing helicoidal shapes. So if you're in a situation where you have a big assembly that takes ages to open and visualizing a thread is not critical, then I'd suggest you try simplifying every bolt and sensor that have a thread and instead use a cosmetic thread, which not only looks pretty, like the name implies, but pretty much makes your models lighter and easier to load. Take this sensor I'm showing for example. It is useful to see a thread, don't get me wrong, but I usually deal with really big assemblies at my work, and every second I could save while loading them is a blessing. Notice that the thread is created with the thread feature with a specific callout, which is great so far. So notice here, this is defined like this, and this is the important bit. Now let's compare the file size of this sensor with and without the thread. The full thread makes the solid roughly 3.2 megabytes in size, while without it we go to just 2.5. Let's look at the performance now. With the whole thread, a single instance of this component takes 0.11 seconds, whereas without the thread, we drop to 0.06, again, roughly half the time. This may not seem like a lot, but consider that this is just a single instance and it's a small file. Now, if I add a cosmetic thread to this face, going to Insert and Annotations and then Cosmetic Thread, then select where the thread would start, I can choose from lots of standards to get my proper thread callout. And it is automatically loaded. Or, if I'd rather, create my own custom thread with my own message. You can also choose how deep the thread goes, be it all the way to the bottom of the face, or maybe just a couple of millimeters. Just like that. Easy, right? Also, whatever you wrote can be loaded easily in a drawing. Just click on the zone where you place the cosmetic thread and right-click until you see the Insert Callout option. You probably will have to look for the dashed lines most of the times. And of course, you can edit it further if you so desire. A cosmetic thread is actually an annotation, like I said, and it will be shown here in the annotations folder in case it hasn't been shown yet. So you may not find this very useful. I don't sometimes too. But if for some reason you're still not seeing the cosmetic thread, then you probably have them hidden. What you may need to do is go to the document properties of the file in question. And in the detailing zone, you need to make sure that you have the cosmetic threads and shaded cosmetic threads checkboxes checked. Also, you will find this one useful. By doing so, then you just need to make sure that you don't have the eye icon turned on, like this, and you will need only this one, the view top level annotation button, and that would be it. Now, if for some reason you're seeing a lot of the feature dimensions, like the diameter of this cylinder and lots of stuff that may cause trouble to your site, then go back to the document properties and uncheck the feature dimensions. This will clean a lot the file. By the way, if you'd still like to drop the file size and rebuild times a lot more, then you could delete some of the surface and solid bodies that aren't very useful. For example, here I have lots of surface and solid bodies that I really can't see because they are underneath other solid bodies and that I will never ever see. And thus, they aren't very helpful to me, they just take up some space. So maybe I could try to delete some of these, if not all of them. And that will make also my file a lot lighter and easier to load. So if you're smart, you will have your design tree shorter cleaner, and you can get the file to half the file size and to open pretty much immediately, like you're seeing. And that is my advice for today. I hope you can make great stuff with all that extra time you will have now. Remember, work smarter, not harder.